We have seen that virtually accessed caches can overlap the latency of the TLB lookup and the cache lookup. However, virtually accessed caches have a big problem called aliasing. The problem of aliasing occurs because in the virtual address space of the application, we can have one page mapped to some part of the physical address space. For example, we can use the mmap function in Linux and other operating systems to map part of a file so that it appears in a range of memory that we can address. The problem occurs when another page in our virtual address space is also mapped to the same physical addresses. For example, when doing an mmap of the same part of the same file to another address. So now what we have is two virtual addresses will actually refer to the same physical location. To see why this is a problem in a virtually accessed cache, let's look at two specific addresses. So let's say that A and B are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 0, 0 and ABCDE 0, 0, 0. And let's say that we have a 64 kilobyte direct map cache with a 16 byte block size and that is virtually accessed. So let's say that this is our 64 kilobyte cache. For this cache, we have a 4-bit offset part of the address because of the 16 byte block size. It's a 64 kilobyte cache, so the next 12 bits are going to be the index into this cache. 64 kilobytes divided by 16 bytes is 4 kilo entries, so we need 2 to the 12 index bits to tell us which index do we have. And the rest of the bits in the addresses are tags. So this is how the aliasing problem occurs. Let's say that the processor writes a value of 16 to A. It breaks down the address, indexes into the cache using the index of hex 500. Let's say that this is a cache miss. So we go to memory, and from the physical location where this data is mapping to, we fetch a value, and let's say that this value is 4. Once we fetch the cache block, we now put 16 there, and the new content of the cache block is 16. Let's say this is a write-back cache, so this 16 just stays there. Now let's see what happens when we try to read B. We index into the cache using the index for B, which is E00 hex, and because what we are looking for is not here, we go to memory and fetch the value, and this maps to the same physical memory location, so we are going to get 4 again. And now we are going to read that. Note that this problem is not just a problem on the cache misses. From now on, whenever we write to A, we will be changing this cache block, and whenever we read from B, we will be reading this cache block, so they never really end up sharing the data as they should. What should have happened is because A and B are really the same data, when we write to A and read B, we should be getting the same data. And this problem results in incorrect execution whenever we have such a mapping. Unfortunately, such mappings are perfectly legal to do in most operating systems, so virtually accessed caches need additional support for this. Every time we write to any virtual location, we would have to do a check for aliases or different versions of the same physical data in the cache and either invalidate them, remove them from the cache, or update them so that they would see the new value. And this is really expensive to do, and it kind of defeats the purpose of virtually accessed caches, which are all about the latency and not needing to do translation. Now, when we write here, we would need to do translation in order to check where else do we have the same mapping. To summarize this, we like virtually accessed caches because they allow us to overlap TLB latency with cache latency, but we cannot use them because of the aliasing problem that seriously complicates their implementation.